I was diagnosed with anorexia nervosa at age 11. It was like a necessity that I needed to change who I was so that I could fit in. Because we place so much emphasis in our culture on worth equaling good looks, that was the distinction I made. The messaging and the ideas and the perceptions and the stereotypes, they're very inescapable. Being that we're so switched on, it's hard to avoid them. I don't think that there was a day in my childhood where I didn't compare myself to someone else. You know, I'd look in the mirror and I'd be like, why can't I look a certain way? Why don't I look like the other guys? You know, this sense of I don't fit in because I don't fit a certain mold. There was a group of guys, probably about four or five. Oh, you're fat, you're disgusting, you're pig. It was up until, you know, the end of primary school, and then sure enough, we all go to the same high school together. You hear this thing about it being, that's just kids being kids. I definitely heard that from parents. You know, oh, they're just being kids, you know, that's just how it is. We all went through it, kind of thing. That's the exact kind of language that propels it. And it's the exact kind of thing that normalizes bullying. Bullying is trauma. I still remember distinct sentences. It starts to build up these beliefs that you have about yourself. So for me, it was the belief that I'm worthless. I don't belong. And they formed very young. And they had many years to form and continue to grow. It got to the point where I felt like I had no way out. I had to say something to someone. And so I opened up to my mum and my dad. Looking back, that took an incredible amount of courage to do that, because it was going to my parents and saying, I need help. In my mind, it is the greatest display of strength and courage and bravery, because you're being vulnerable with someone. I was showing them a wound and I needed them to help heal it.